Oregon EMS Data System, EMS Agency Administrator Training, Managing and Using Reports. This session is for EMS agency administrators. We'll show you how to access, use, and manage the patient care reports in your agency in Oregon's ImageTrend Elite data system. Then we'll show you a brief overview of the ImageTrend Report Writer and discuss how you can collect hospital outcomes from the hospitals to which you transport patients. Most of this training session is a hands-on practice, so we encourage you to shrink this video into one corner of your screen, then bring up a web browser and follow along in ImageTrend Elite, logged in with your own user account. This is the ImageTrend Elite login page. You can get to it by going to imagetrendelite.com/elite with a capital E. The organization ID is Oregon. Use your own user account to log into the system. If you don't know your user account information, please contact the Oregon Health Authority using the support contacts that we'll provide at the end of this session. Let's review some highlights about managing patient care reports in ImageTrend Elite. We're going to start by going to the Tools menu and choosing Form Manager. The Form Manager allows you to set up data entry forms that can be used by your EMTs and paramedics as they fill out patient care reports. We've already created 3 data entry forms at the system-wide level. The default form is EMS Oregon. This data entry form contains all of the data elements that are collected statewide within Oregon. The second form is called EMS Oregon Plus. It contains all of the elements that are in the EMS Oregon form, plus some additional data elements that are useful to many EMS agencies in the state, including elements related to odometer readings and billing. The third form is the EMS Oregon non-transport form. If you are a non-transporting EMS agency, this would be the most appropriate form for you to use. It eliminates the data elements that would only be pertinent to transports. You can decide which form should be the default form within your agency. By selecting that form, for example, I'm selecting EMS Oregon Plus, and clicking Set Default. That form is now the default form for my agency. If you want to make sure that that's the only form available within your agency, then you can select the other forms and select Inactivate. Now, the EMS Oregon Plus form is not only the default form, but it's the only form available for EMTs and paramedics to use in your agency. You can make your own run forms. You can either start with one of the system forms and copy it, and we highly recommend doing that because the EMS Oregon form contains all of the data elements that are required in the state of Oregon. Then you can just add to it. Or on the left-hand side, you can click to create a new EMS form. To show you what the form manager looks like, I'm going to choose to copy the EMS Oregon form. This form will be at my agency level, and I need to make a name for this form. Now I see the demo agency form that I just created as a copy of EMS Oregon, and the source for that is demo agency, my agency, which means that I can edit that form. I'll click on it to begin editing it. This interface provides me an editor where I can add and remove data elements on my form. For example, if I wanted to add additional information to collect on the dispatch panel, I could search the data set for the element that I want to add. Look through the elements and say, for example, that I would like to add EMD card number to the form. Then I can click and drag that over onto the form. I've now added EMD card number to my agency run form. So when EMTs and paramedics in my agency are filling out their patient care reports, it will ask them for EMD card number. I can also set a default value for that data element. I can rearrange the sections and panels and the elements within my run form design. In addition to the main form layout, I can manage a times data entry page, a mileage data entry page, and additional worksheets. Worksheets are used to collect additional information that is just specific to your agency and is not contained anywhere in the Nemesis data standard. The changes that I make to my form are automatically saved as I go. So when I'm done, I can simply click back to return to the list of forms. Next, let's look at where to find patient care reports that have been filled out by the staff in your agency. Those are in the Incidents menu. And you can go to View Existing EMS to get a list of patient care reports in your agency. This will show me the most recent patient care reports, but I can choose how I want to sort them. I can also choose a date range that I want to filter the reports to. And I can choose an incident status. For example, I could look at all reports that have been marked complete, or that are still in progress and still need to be marked complete, or reports that have been marked as ready to send to billing. If my agency had reports that had been flagged as needing review or as having been billed, then those statuses would show up here as well. I can select a patient care report by clicking on it, and I can deselect it by clicking again. I can select multiple patient care reports. Then I can use the Bulk Actions menu to lock or unlock those reports, to export them, to change their status, for example, to mark several reports as completed or ready for billing, or to create print reports. I'm going to select just one patient care report and choose from the Bulk Actions menu to create print report. This will ask me how I want the system to generate the report, as an online print view or as a PDF that I could download and save. And then it will ask me which print report template to use. You can set up additional templates in your agency, but this one, the Oregon EMS Patient Care Report template, has been set up as a good starting point for statewide use. I click OK, and it generates the printable version of my patient care report. If I need to edit a patient care report, I can click the arrow on the right-hand side, and that will take me into the data entry area to make changes to that report. There's another powerful way to get information about the patient care reports that are in the system. As we look at the EMS incident list, we see individual patient care reports, and we can go into the details of each report. But sometimes you want summary-level reporting. You want to look across all of your patient care reports, to look at things like how many calls did you go on in a particular month, or what is your average response time or scene time. The tool for that is located in the Tools menu, and it's called Report Writer. We won't provide a full training on the Report Writer in this session, but we'll show you a screenshot of the capabilities. Here's a sample from Report Writer. This particular sample is a chart that looks at the number of calls that you've had by day of week. There are many other predefined reports in Report Writer that you can use. You can also customize those reports, make adjustments to them that are specific to you and your needs, and you can create new reports from scratch. For training on using Report Writer, please contact the Oregon Health Authority, and we'll be happy to provide that training. Finally, let's discuss hospital outcome reporting. In Oregon's ImageTrend Elite system, hospital staff can access your patient care reports for patients delivered to their hospital. They also have the opportunity to record hospital outcomes attached to those patient care reports. If they record hospital outcomes for a patient care report, then you can access those hospital outcomes. This is what a hospital user sees when they log into the system. They get a list of all patient care reports incoming to their hospital. And if they click on the Outcome button, they can enter information about the hospital outcome for a patient delivered to their hospital. The information that they record is connected or attached to your patient care report. And you can view that information by accessing a printable version of a patient care report from the incident list or by using a report in the report writer. We encourage you to talk to the hospitals that you work with and discuss with them the possibility of using this hospital outcome reporting feature in ImageTrend Elite. The Oregon Health Authority has a couple of documents available that provide an overview of this feature and how to use it. If you have additional questions about how to use patient care reports in your system and how to do data analysis or reporting, please contact the Oregon Health Authority using the information provided on this screen. You can also access online help through ImageTrend University. If you have general questions about the Nemsys data standard that we use, you can visit the Nemsys website.